If the force between the electron in the first Bohr orbit and the nucleus given proton in a hydrogen atoms is F, then the force between them when the electron is in the second orbit is. Generally we know, according to the Coulomb's inverse square law, F is equal to, this is the K into Q1 Q2 by R square, where Q, we know, this is the 1 by 4 pi epsilon naught. And here let us write, this is the F is inversely proportional to R square. Why? Because K being constant, Q1, Q2 also, they become constant. Only R value will be changed. Through that, let us write, F is inversely proportional to, that means F1 is inversely proportional to R1 square. F2 is inversely proportional to, this is R2 square. If we take the F1 by F2 ratio, F1 by F2 is equal to, this should be equal to, this is R2 by R1 whole square. But in the question they said, the radius of the first Bohr's orbit, we know the standard formula, radius of nth orbit of the Bohr, which is equal to epsilon naught h square by, this is pi m e square, that is into n square. And here we know the value, radius of the first orbit, which is equal to 0.53 angstrom, radius of the second orbit 2.2 angstrom. Now taking the substitution, let us write F1 by F2, which is equal to R2, 2.12 by 0.53, this is the whole square. Already they said force, initial force is the F by F2, which is equal to, which is nearly 16. After doing that, then F2 is equal to, we got F by 16. Here this is the force in the second orbit, and here the fourth option is the right option.